derivation of price consumption curve. I believe the viewers have sufficient knowledge in consumer equilibrium. If you have any doubt about your understanding of indifference curve, price line and consumer equilibrium, kindly view them first. A good grounding on them is a prerequisite for what we are going to discuss in this lesson. I have given the links in the description. Price consumption curve traces the price effect. Price effect studies the effect of a change in the price on the change in the quantity consumed of a good. Look at this graph. As usual, good Y is measured along the Y axis and good X is measured along the X axis. Given the income of the consumer and the prices of the two goods, we get the price line PL1. Indifference curve IC1 is tangent to the price line at point E1. The consumer is in equilibrium at that point. He consumes M1 units of good X. As we are going to trace the price consumption curve for good X, we shall focus on the quantity consumed of that good. Now let us see what happens to the quantity consumed of good X when its price falls. Income of the consumer and the price of good Y remaining constant. The price of good X falls. If the consumer spends his entire income on good X, he can buy more. So the point L1 moves to the right. The new price line is PL2. It is relatively flat. The consumer is in equilibrium at E2. He buys M2 units of good X. M2 is more than M1. The successive fall in the price of good X is given by price lines PL3 and PL4. In these price lines, the consumer is in equilibrium at E3 and E4 respectively. The quantity purchased at E3 is M3 and at E4 is M4. As the price of good X falls, the quantity purchased increases as M1, M2, M3 and M4 units. Join the equilibrium points E1, E2, E3 and E4. What we get is the price consumption curve, PCC. In the present case, the PCC is falling to the right. It means successive fall in the price of good X makes the consumer to consume more and more. The fall in the price of good X results in the increasing quantity of it to be purchased. Moreover, the downward sloping PCC signifies that good X is a normal one. This need not be the case of PCC always. Look at this graph. PCC slopes upwards from right to left. To begin with, the consumer buys M4 units. With fall in the price, the other price lines are formed. As the price falls, the consumer buys less and less quantity of good X, that is M3, M2 and M1 units. Here, good X is a given good. Thus, the shape of the price consumption curve helps us to identify the type of good that is measured along the x-axis. Choose the correct answer. Income of the consumer and the price of good Y remaining constant. A fall in the price of good X brings about a new price line. The new price line is A. Parallel to the original price line. B. Relatively flat. C. To the left of the original price line. D. More steep than the previous one. E. None of the above. If your answer is B, you are right. In the next video, we shall see price consumption curve and elasticity of demand.